This is Doug Sillars with the AT&T Developer Program with another quick tip on how to use ARO. When you look at the Diagnostic tab, you see a wealth of information. We can see the throughput of the data going through on the trace. We can see the packets being uploaded, downloaded. They're grouped into bursts. We can see any user inputs that may have happened, and we see a model of the RRC Radio Resource Control state machine. We can also see a table of all the TCP and UDP flows, and if we select them, we can see information about each one of those flows. However, did you know that there are more things that you can view in this top table? By going to View and Options, you can see that there are many other selections that you can look at. We can see the GPS state, we can see the signal strength, if Bluetooth, camera, screen, how the battery performed, the network type, the wake locks, CPU usage, and alarm. Let's click a couple and see what happens. We'll do CPU usage, battery, signal strength, and network type. Now we can see several things. We can see that the signal strength jumped right here while the throughput dropped. So the signal strength went from, if you mouse over these dots, we'll see the signal strength was minus 118. And up here, it went to minus 99. We can see the network type here was LTE, but we dropped to HSPA plus here. This actually explains why the throughput went from high to low, because the signal, the radio type changed during the trace. We can also see that during this trace, the battery went from 52% to 40%. And we can also see the CPU usage was relatively high, about 55% through much of the trace. This information can help you better understand what your application is doing while you're taking the network trace, so you can figure out how to improve the performance of your application. Thanks for watching, and stay tuned for more tips in the coming weeks.